This sports segment of the Suburban Radio Hour is brought to you by the Montreal Alliance. Get your tickets to professional basketball now at alliancemontreal.ca.
And welcome back to Suburban Radio Hour on CJD 800. I'm Beryl Wiseman, editor of the Suburban, with my good friends and colleagues, Anthony Bonaparte, features editor, Mark Ledbetter, sports editor. Mark, you have a very special guest today.
That's right.
A champion young lady from the West Island.
From Dollard, I have Hannah Stopnicki, who has just made a sweet repeat on as the champion of the U.S. Junior Masters event down in Georgia. And Hannah, it's great to have you here, and it's nice to talk to you again.
It's so good to talk to you, too. How are you today?
Excellent, excellent. Now, listen, that's something. Congratulations on that, because I'm sure this event, the talent pool is quite tough. So it really must have challenged you to come up on top of the podium again.
Yeah, 100%. Going into the event was a lot of ups and downs. I've had this one girl who I've been in close competition with for the last 2 years or so, and we keep on going back and forth. I've been doing really good at the kind of bigger events, and I somehow end up on top, I guess, with all the hard work and training. But I was a little bit nervous about her, and I worked really hard with my coach on just focusing on myself and my process. And it went my way, and I was really, really excited about that. But yeah, there was some ups and downs, and it was a struggle to get there. Well, not to get there, but it was a struggle to be there and be top seed and everything, and it turned out really well.
Now, you get two passes to impress the judges, right?
Yeah, pretty much. So it's 2 20-second passes, and you're trying to get as many high scoring tricks as possible in that time. So that'll consist of the first pass will be a toe pass. So you're doing spins standing on one leg, and then your other leg is holding the rope, and you're spinning in and out of the line. And then your second pass will be you're holding onto the rope with your hands, and you're on your one ski, and you get to do spins and also flips on that one.
Were you comfortable after your first pass thinking, you know, I did pretty good with that. I'm feeling good going into the second set.
The first pass went in the, so there's the prelims and the finals. The preliminary round is everyone. And then the finals, the top three make it. So in the prelims, it's a little bit less high stress just because you just kind of have to get it done. You don't have to go for the win right there and then. But it is stressful just in that, like, if you mess up, then you're not even in the final. So my coach always says you can lose, you can't win in the prelim, but you sure can lose, and you don't want to do that. So going into after the first pass, it's a little bit of a relief just because for me, my first pass is stronger than a lot of the girls. A lot of the girls have a stronger second pass. And so going into it, I get to do my first pass. And if I do everything properly, it's just over 4,000 points, which being top seed puts me already in a decent position where I don't even have to do quite as much in the second run to make it into the final. But I felt really good about it. There was some room for improvement, which I did in the final, actually. And then my hand pass, I actually almost fell on my second flip.
I watched the video. Yeah. You recovered nicely though.
Yeah. So I was, I guess, a little nervous. And the thing about Robin Lake is it's movey. The water, it moves, and there's waves and rollers, and it's a hard place to ski. And I guess I hit a roller, and it kind of just like I went like, whoa, okay, relax. You got to get everything settled. And I mean, I landed that second flip, almost missed it, went straight back into the next one, which almost feels better than doing everything perfectly, because you kind of, it's like, I handled that, and handling something, it's a really important skill to have. And so I handled it, moved into the next one, then almost fell on my last flip, but I was not letting go. I stomped it, and my face was in the water, but I made it out. I survived it.
Now you're training and working, and what's ahead for you this summer?
Yeah, so I'm actually really excited about this time because it's been a long 2 years of just pro or international tournaments back to back to back to back. And finally now after the Masters, I'm going into a period where I've got some little tournaments and some pro tournaments. Like I'm going to Europe for just under 2 weeks. I'm going to a pro tournament in Monaco and another one in Madrid. But those ones, I'll be competing against the pros, so I wouldn't be going to win yet. Hopefully one day we'll get there.
Learning experience.
Yeah, so those are kind of the little ones. I'm going to do the nationals at the end of the year, but for me, that's kind of just become another tournament to get a good score and to try to go and support all the other younger juniors coming up. So this is a good time for me to really develop. I landed 3 new tricks this week, and the last time I landed a new trick was 15 months ago. So I'm really trying to just progress and get to that next level in this like time where I'm not as tournament go, go, go.
Excellent. Excellent. Listen, it's great to catch up with you. Continued success. Show those pros. And now you're going to be a little bit of a mentor because at what, 18 years old, I guess you're over the hill with the juniors, right?
Yeah, I've got one more junior event. It's in Australia next year, but that's it. So
that's it. Good stuff.
Yeah.
Well, it's good to speak with you, Hannah. All the best to you and the family and continued success.
Thank you. Thank you so much. It's good to speak to you too.
Okay, that was terrific, and we wish her well, and she looks like she's going to have a great career, and she's certainly entitled to it, and really works really hard. We had a West End, West Island game this week that was interesting.
Little confrontation between the NDG Lynx and the PRFI Yankees, and the Lynx earned a 9-4 road win over the Yankees in Lac St. Louis 18UB baseball. That was at the George Springgate Park in PRFI. And NDG's Sam Abramovich and Justin Melville combined to quiet the Yankees' bats in 3 of the 5 innings played. The visitors scored first and never relinquished their lead, with PRFI getting to but within 1 run in the 3rd inning, but couldn't add any more to their total. And the Lynx pulled away in their final at-bats, pushing 4 runs across the plate for the road victory. And then we had also Saint Laurent. They held on for a determined Lakeshore squad. They took a 5-3 decision over their Lakeshore counterparts in Lac St. Louis Development League U13 soccer. And it was a 4-goal performance by Racine Benzino, who broke open a 1-1 contest to deliver the win to the visitors. But it wasn't an easy win, as Lakeshore pressed and were rewarded to make it a 5-3 contest, but ran out of time to pull even with Saint Laurent. Lakeshore ran into a hot keeper, as St. Laurent's Nabil Hassabo was spot on handling several quality challenges by Lakeshore.
And getting off just the local scene, but there's a Canada-Mexico confrontation, as you would say.
Yeah, it was a summer send-off series as they prepare for the Olympics in Paris. And in the first of 2 friendlies against Mexico, Canada's national women's soccer team took a 2-0 decision. And that was in front of 5,319 fans at Stade Saputo last Saturday afternoon. Game 2 took place on Tuesday evening at Toronto's BMO Field, where the two sides played to a 1-1 draw. Now, it took a pair of second-half goals, though, in the game here in Montreal to open up a 0-0 score that gave the Roos the decision they were looking for. Canada's keeper Kaylin Sheridan earned the clean sheet with some help from Quebec's Vanessa Giles, and Canada's both goals came in late in the game with Chloe Lacasse and Evelyn Vienne setting that up. But she was also a great game by Mexico's keeper Celeste Espino, holding them off until that time.
And next week you got coming up?
Legends of Soccer match in Pointe Claire for charity. Sirwa against Lakeshore, and Laval takes on Lac St. Louis in baseball, plus Habs bursary recipients.
Okay. Gentlemen, thank you. Thank you, listeners. And we hope to see many of you this Saturday. I want to remind you again, June 15th at Centennial Park in Beaconsfield from 10 to 5. On the Suburban Family Day. Family and Pet Day, I forgot. Yes, Anthony, Family and Pet Day. Have a great week.
This sports segment of the Suburban Radio Hour is brought to you by the Montreal Alliance. Get your tickets to professional basketball now at alliancemontreal.ca.